Fox asked Darren Star to shoot the scene two ways, with a kiss and without.
So, does Billy know?
Nah, we've never talked about it. I mean, I was basically straight in college, and since then, there just never seemed to be the right time to bring it up.
Yeah, well, I'm sure he'd be fine with it.
I refused to deliver them that version of the show that they kind of wanted. And then I said, look, if you guys are going to make any cuts in this, you have to do it, because I'm certainly not going to do it.
Well, listen, good night. I'll see you tomorrow.
Yeah, good night.
We shot the kiss, sent it, and then they basically sort of cut out the actual kiss. It was frustrating, but at the same time, it was like incredibly silly. It would have shocked nobody, and I think that was the whole point. I was like, there's nothing shocking about this, you know?
Television is starting to accept gay characters, but it absolutely panics at the prospect of two men kissing. What is the big deal?
For television in general, but certainly in the case of gay people, kissing is the metaphor for intercourse. When a same-sex kiss is broached by producers or writers or, you know, a program, it becomes an occasion for cultural struggle. It also becomes an occasion to build your ratings.
I kissed everybody, I think. I kissed everybody, every woman on that show. It was great fun for me. I loved it.
It was sweeps lesbianism. It was the kiss on Roseanne. It was, you know, Abby's one, little experiment on L.A. Law.
For some odd reason, it seems that in American culture, straight guys really love the idea of seeing a couple of women have at it. They don't feel quite the same way about seeing a couple of men have at it, or at least they rarely admit it.
Television can't seem to get enough of lovely ladies locking lips on shows like Ally McBeal.
I think there were a lot of people who were turned off by that. And I think other people were like, what time is it on? I want to watch it.
At the time, sweeps lesbianism is the only lesbianism on television. Unless, of course, someone is looking very carefully.
At the very beginning of, we were editing the main title of XENA. And there's a shot in the main title where Lucy was kissing a man, but it was a man who had long hair, and he was shot from the back. And I remember someone from the studio called and said, you have to get that shot out because he looks like a woman and people are going to think that she's gay. And I said, guys, look, I'm gay. And when I go to the supermarket with my girlfriend, people keep asking us if we're sisters. And, you know, my girlfriend isn't white. So I said, no one is going to think that they're gay. Six episodes in, it's all over the internet that everybody's saying, well, she and Gabrielle, I clearly love her. Did you see that thing?
And the lesbian community certainly made XENA a lesbian in their own minds.
The show's creators log on and take notice of XENA's growing fan base.
There was an episode that opened with XENA and Gabrielle swimming in a pond, and it sounds like they're talking, like they're having sex.
Come on, Gabrielle. You've been wanting to do this for ages. Just reach under this rock. Give it your best shot.
Okay.
And then you realize, oh, they're fishing. You know, of course they're fishing naked because, you know, it's XENA. So I think that was the first time I remember us going, okay, we're going to, let's play with the fact that of what people are thinking.